Hi, I'm Angela Grunig. I want to welcome you to my program today, The Awakening. I am here with such a dear friend. I'm in Holland. And Pastor Jannie, say your name.
Yes, my name is Jannie Kloosterman.
See, that everybody knows if I had even said her name, I would mess that up. But you are one of the most greatest women, heroes of the faith. Like, even though I'm in Holland, and I still feel like women are very pushed down here, y'all better get ready, because God says I'm lifting off that lid, and it's time for the women to roar alongside the lions, because the lioness have something to say as well. You are such an amazing, you're a pastor. I want you to take some time, because she worries about her English, but she speaks very good English. But I want you to talk a little bit about what you're doing in your meetings and what the name of your churches and stuff like that. Yeah.
Yes, I'm a pastor of a church for a lot of people from the street, and I like the people from the street because they are broken, and I like it that I see that they come back in the also in the world and can do the work with the talents and the gifts that God gives them to them. And I'm a pastor of this church. And also I do a lot of women's meetings, and I preach in other places also in this nation, in Holland. Mm-hmm. And God opened more and more doors to preach the gospel. And I see a lot of miracles. Also the last years, miracles has happened. Also in the traditional church, mm-hmm. we see that pastors working together with us. And that's for the first time in 30 years.
Wow.
And also in places in other churches that no women can preach, we can preach there. And we invite her to come to preach the gospel. And we see that also in Holland, a lot of people give their life to Jesus.
Yes.
And they want hear the back of the truth word, and not cold word, but a warm word, the truth. So yeah. We see that a lot of people make choices before mm-hmm. Jesus, and to radical choices. Also
yes.
the young people. And what we see all the last time is that a lot of children give their life to Jesus and to pray with the old people and to prophesy, and they pray in the church. And that is what I very like, because also in our own church, young people stand up and preach and pray for us and prophesy and all that stuff, and give words of God and visions of God. And yeah, that is what I like. Mm-hmm. And also young people give their life to Jesus. And also my son is give his life to Jesus, and that
Come
is for
on.
Me a great miracle, because
yes.
he's 23 and he lives in very darkness, and now he make a choice for Jesus.
Yes.
And that is what I love, and I see that he take also a lot of young people, mm-hmm. yeah, he take them from the world and bring them to Jesus.
Yes.
And now what we see, and that is what I like, that people make a choice before Jesus.
Yeah.
To radical and not half, but full.
Because they're going full throttle. Okay, so there's a couple things that you said that are such a key tonight and today for many people that are watching. Listen, there are other pastors out there that are women like us and that are having a real hard time going through. Because in America, no matter where we live, women, there's always still like it's hard, you know?
Yeah.
And God says it's not, because the Holy Spirit is not male nor female. And so God is moving powerfully. But one of the greatest things about you, besides that you really are my girlfriend, and I truly love and honor you so much, but I love your heart is ferocious for the streets. Y'all know me, I'm all about the streets. But your heart is for the streets.
Yeah.
And I remember years ago, I went to your house, and there was an extension from the house, huge room. I go, what's this for? She goes, oh, this is where all the kids come from the streets. And
yeah.
I said, God, I love her even more. Because it is about going for the broken and the lost. And I also love, you said about the young people, that they're able to have a voice. Listen, God is creating a culture now for the young people to have a place, but they must be trained up in the way they should go, even as young adults coming out of darkness into the light. And you're a light bearer, a light giver. And that's what I love about you. We have so much fun. Like, we haven't seen each other in years. And in 2 seconds, we're falling out laughing, because when you're really family, you step right back into that place and time. And I want to just say this to our viewing audience, but to all of our media hosts that are with us. But this is Pastor Jannie. You are shown on television more than you know. And I talk about you really all the time. And I'll tell you why I do. Because I say, You know, I love that we could do like the television and the media, and we have a new studio now. I haven't really been there yet, but I'll be there soon. I've been quite busy lately. And I love that. And they said, we love that it's not about the HD and it's not about this and it's not about that. But you go into Romania, yeah. And that's the key tonight I want to talk about. So you're going into Romania.
Yes.
And what are you doing there? I mean, some people saw a little bit about what you do from your media, and you are working on your television right now, yes? Yes.
Yes.
You know me, I'm like, yes. But can you share some about some of the things that are going on for Romania?
Yes, we go to Romania, and then I preach for the Roma people. They are very broken, and no one gives them something, and they have no food and no houses and all that stuff. So we give them money to buy food, and we help them, we pray for them. Mm-hmm. And I preaching also there for the women, and I go to the churches there to preach in Romania. And I like that country very, very much.
Yes.
Yes.
Romania is, to you, Pakistan to me.
Yeah, second home.
Yes.
Yes.
There's like something about it. I was invited recently to go to Israel, and I was like, well, I don't know. I've been invited so many times to go to Israel, but if you go to Pakistan and Israel, you kind of can't cross the border. But it, like, your Romania is my Pakistan, and I just love that we have these opportunities, that we're going into places. And listen, it is 2017, but it's really about reaching the lost for Christ. It really is. There's nothing like winning souls. I just put out a word on the prophetic networks, and at the end, I just kept saying, God, give me souls, lest I die. I want those that are in great darkness, but that's where your heart is.
Uh-huh.
But I love your heart because of the Romanian people are so precious. Now, there's been so much oppression there and war, is that correct?
Yeah, there is a lot of depression, also for the women, because they have a difficult time also in the marriage, and there is no money, they must work, and are the children left at home alone. So it is a bad place. If you see this, then I cry a lot.
Of course. Well, because you know what it is? Whether you're living in Holland or where you're living at in the world, you know, we have such an abundance from God.
Yeah.
And I think a lot of people take that for granted. Like, yeah, whatever. Unless you've been on the streets and you have to get up, like, I feed all the time for 30 years on the streets, but I can go home and get a shower and open up the refrigerator. But every time I'm out there, I thank God that I have a shower and I can open up a refrigerator and have food. Where many people are out in the streets, or they're lost and broken in drugs because they're filling a void that only Christ can fill.
Yeah.
And I say this in America, you're little fat cats and you got everything you need and you want everybody to give me, give me, give me. But God says to his sons and daughters, we have got to give back what has been given to us. And so what would be something that you would say to pastors right now? Because I believe there are a lot of pastors that are broken right now. Like, you know, hopeless would be my word, but yeah. I mean, what you can speak in your language. You can say a prayer, whatever you sense right now.
Yeah.
I want you to feel that.
No, I think that we live in a time that the truth must be preached everywhere. We can be open doors, and we receive open doors from God.
Yeah.
We can preach the truth. I believe that God will come back with his glory also in this country and other places. But we need also to be in unity. I think that is what I see in a vision was this. I saw Europe, and I saw a very black cloud was coming about Europe. And I saw God was sitting on his throne, and I was crying, say, God, you can hold back this black cloud. What is the reason that it is come? And God was sitting, and he sit there. I say, God, you can stand up, and you can put your hand so you can back. And then God said, you must be a walk in unity. And I believe this is the very way that when we go together in unity and to, that may come back a great love before Jesus. And I ask Jesus, you live with the Father in unity. What is the reason that you can live in unity with the Father? And Jesus told me through his Holy Spirit, he said, I love my Father so much. And that is the reason that I take time for the Father, that I go on the mountains all the time and take a lot of time with the Father.
Absolutely.
And he said, if you love me back again and take time and you come in the Holy of Holies place, I can give you the strategies. And you can go fight in the darkness, and you can take your back, your country take back. And that is the reason, and I pray further that moment when I saw this, God told me, he said, you need a lot of humility. If people walk, and also the pastors, I believe, if we walk in humility and no mask before our faces and to real and to and walk in truth and not, how do I say, a pure and a right and a clean life, I believe that God can do a lot of things. And that is what happened in my own life. 4 years ago, I was very ill and almost I was dead. And that year, I was walking 2 years, and the doctors don't know what I have. And this 2 years, God has showed me a lot in my own heart. And it's, for me, was a very bad time, but I believe this, if the Holy Spirit can touch us and with His light, He can shine in our hearts. Yes. So the darkness can put away in our own hearts. And so the light is coming back in our hearts. Mm-hmm. And that is what happened in my life. It was a very bad time, but also a very good time, because God has changed my heart. And so now we see a lot of things, and the glory of God is coming back.
Yes, and you know, it really is about the humility. Listen, what you do not honor, you will never have. You may not like someone, you might not like the way they look or the way they act or agree, like per se, but the bottom line is that what you don't honor, you'll never have. And what you don't value will fall through. And everything you ever loved will be gone. You know, God says it's all about humility and being humble before the King. In Yom Kippur of last year in October, I was crying in Kentucky, and we were just out with our Deliverance Healing Center. And I had just finished doing interviews because it's amazing the things God's doing. And I started to cry. I was weeping. I'm not a crier, but I couldn't stop weeping. And I said, Father, is there a word you could give me? And I opened up my Bible, and I just put it out on the media, because I don't care anymore. If people understand the glory, you do. And if you don't, then sad for you. That's all I can say, you know?
Yep.
And but if the word was on the Shekinah glory, I opened up the word, and the gold just poured and poured. And I didn't even see the gold, to be honest. I looked down, and all I could see was the Beatitudes. And the Father said, you know, I was on that mountain, everyone was healed. God says, when we all come up together, we're all going to get healed. And that's really what it was about. Because I'm like, if we don't get souls brought into the kingdom, who will? Will you go? I mean, will you be the feet that Christ is calling and ordaining? Listen, all of us are called into the reconciliation. Each one of us has destiny. And we have purpose in our life. Even if you think or feel like, well, I'm not feeling it, we'll get over it, because it ain't about what you feel anyway. It's about what you know to be true. It's about God's word. It's always true.
Yes.
And that's where we're at. Like, you got stuck with your children. I've had things with mine. We've had things with our health. But, you know, God always, if we will persevere, you know, that's my word for this year for me, that He said in 2017, you must persevere like you've never before. And my face has to be older. I'm at the wall constantly, and I can't get off. I feel a lot being pulled right now. But I want those that are in great darkness to come into the light.
Yes.
What a sad day. You know, I love the word. It says, you know, in Luke 11, but He says, you know, there are names waiting to be written in the Lamb's Book of Life. And can you imagine if we weren't in His book? To be separated. There's so many young people on the streets. I want all the young people. That's why I work. I just finished a conference a few months ago. Over 600,000 people in great darkness, sex slave trade. I mean, and it's legal in California. It's horrific. Folsom Street Fair. I mean, it's so bad. And people say, why do you go? And I go, because I can. And it was so amazing, though, because you see all these people. They're chained and being whipped, and it's S&M. I mean, so filthy, so dark. And I can't get it out of my head, because they call me pastor there and mama, and they cry because they go, she doesn't jam God down my throat. She's not sitting here crucifying me. She gives me words. I cry. I know that I'm loved. Look, our job is to love people. I'm not God. I'm not a dictator. Some of you, that's what your problem is. You're dictating your people. That's why you have problems right now in your churches. But God said it's God so loved the world. God's love is what pours. And in September of 2017, now that we're saying this, but Yanni will be with me in Germany, because when I was going to Folsom Street Fair in September of last year, I've just completed 3 years there, and I take teams in and train them. And I was like, Lord, I knew in my spirit, the Father really spoke very clearly. He said, well, there's more Folsom Streets. And I was like, well, yeah, there must be. And I was like, Lord, you know, the one place I don't want to go is Germany. And you know where it's at? In Germany. And because there's a major demonic gate there, it's one of the top three satanic gates. And I said, Lord, you know I don't want to go there. And where are you going to send me? Right to that gate. And it's just interesting because right after I said yes to the Lord, everything started to shift and there was the bombing. They just hit one of the places I'll be at. Is my husband goes, is that where you're going? I go, yeah, it's right there. Of course it is. Because when danger hits, I'm going in. But can you imagine the souls that are going to come into the kingdom? And if you can't come so into our ministries, help us to get there. I'm going to Germany if I have to walk, because I will, because I know I have to, because it is an area, if we don't go start going after the dark, it's overtaking. It is overtaking. People go, oh, that's not true. Yes, it is. The darkness is overtaking so many places. And people are like, oh, I can't do this. I can't. Yes, you can. You can't because you don't believe. You don't have a faith to pray to believe. Faith is spelled R-I-S-K. It's called risk. And you got to become a risk taker to do the work of the Lord. Fear is a false evidence that appears real. I'm just tired of stupid. I say that all the time. I'm just stupid on stupid. I'm tired of it. We got to wake up. God says, you've already been set free. What are you waiting for?
Yeah.
You know, that's what I love about it. You're going. She said it. Yes.
Yes.
Woo! She's going. You got to close this out. But I want you to pray in your language. Just pray whatever. But I'm going to tell you what you see is what you see. Woo! That's why we're sisters to the end. But, I love that you call yourself, because she really is a pastor as well. But you have such an apostolic prophetic rods of authority.
Yep.
And the Father says, I'm getting ready to take you into a whole new dimension, not a season, but a new dimension and place.
Yes.
And because you are so honoring that I see favor laying all over you, an uncommon favor for future things to come that are going to just rock your world and rock everybody else's out there. Y'all don't want to mess with her because I'll just come get you. Because I can. And that is the thing. Yeah. So whatever you got, go for it, honey. Just pray us out.
Am I laying with?
Yes!
Okay.
Shut up, honey.
Vader God, dank u wel, Heer, dat we mogen bidden. Dank u wel, Vader, wanneer wij u aanroepen, Heer, dat u antwoordt. Heer, dank u wel, Heer, dat u in ieder geroepen hebt, Heer, om een krachtig werk voor u te doen, Vader. Heer, en u verlangt dat uw glorie opnieuw wordt gezien over deze wereld. Heer, u verlangt, Heer, dat uw licht zal doorbreken, Heer, in de ganse wereld, Vader. Heer, ik wil u danken, Heer, dat u uw volk aan het oprichten bent en aan het herstellen bent. Vader, ik wil u danken, Heer, dat u in ieder van ons gaat uitzenden, Vader. Heer, dat niemand meer tijd gaat verspelen. Vader, Heer, ik wil u danken dat uw woord weer wordt geopend, Vader. Heer, dat de gouden schatten weer uit uw woord kunnen komen, Vader. Heer, dat we het goud van u weer kunnen brengen in deze wereld. Vader, ik wil u bidden, Heer, dat u ons een nieuw hart gaat geven, een hart wat bewogen is. Heer, een hart wat in vuur en vlam staat voor uw Zoon, Jezus Christus. Heer, een hart, Heer, wat vol van passie voor u is, Vader. Heer, dat de liefde van u ons zal drijven om deze wereld in te gaan. Heer, ik wil u bidden dat we ons niet zullen tegen laten houden door angst of vrees of wat dan ook, Vader. Heer, maar dat we zullen gaan, Vader. Heer, van overwinning naar overwinning, van glorie naar glorie. Heer, dat u zal meewerken, uw woord zal worden bevestigd met wonderen en tekenen. En Vader, ik bid dat u uw volk moed en kracht gaat geven. Heer, dat we moed krijgen om uw woord recht te prediken. Heer, dat we kracht krijgen om uw woord recht te brengen. Vader, ik bid dat alles, Heer, wat mensen wil behagen, dat u het wegneemt, ook in lijdens, Vader. Heer, ik wil u bidden, Vader, dat we niet bevreesd zijn om mensen te verliezen. Heer, maar dat we bevreesd zijn in een goede ontzag voor uw Vader. Heer, dat we niet zullen willen dat onze naam uit uw boek zal worden gewist, Vader. En daarom bid ik, Vader, Heer, zet uw moed vrij. En elk kind van u op dit moment, in Jezus' naam. Heer, ik bid dat u ons doopt met uw heilig vuur. Heer, dat we vurige ballen voor u zullen gaan worden, die deze wereld in brand zullen gaan brengen, voor Koning Jezus Christus. En ik bid, Heer, geef ons een boldness vanuit uw troon, om uw woord recht te prediken, om te spreken wat er gesproken moet worden, en om te doen wat er gedaan moet worden, Heer. Heer, dat u gebieden gaat openbreken. En Vader, ik bid, waar de duisternis op dit moment nog macht heeft, Vader. Heer, wat deuren nog gesloten zijn, die open moeten gaan voor uw koninkrijk. Heer, we bidden deze deuren, we spreken deze deuren open in Jezus Christus' naam. Heer, voor elk kind van u, dat we ons niet laten tegenhouden. Vader, maar dat u ons een sterkte vanuit uw troon gaat geven, om de deuren als het ware open te breken en binnen te gaan daar waar u ons zendt. Heer, daar waar wij binnenkomen, komt u binnen en zal uw licht doorbreken in duisternis. En ik dank u, Vader, Heer, dat u uw kinderen gaat gebruiken. Ik dank danken, Heer, dat we een leger aan het oprichten bent. Heer, soldaten die niet bevreesd of beangst zijn, maar die zullen weten wie ze zijn in de naam van de Allerhoogste Heer. Heer, zo zegen ik in iedereen in Jezus' naam. En ook Angela, ook haar man, Heer, haar gezin en ook haar bediening. Heer, we vragen uw machtige zegen over haar gehele werk heen. Dat haar gebied mag vergroten ook het komende jaar. Heer, het uw licht, Heer, uw inzicht, uw openbaringen zullen gaan toenemen. Tot eer en tot glorie van Jezus Christus' naam. Amen en amen.
See, I told you, she's like me, a pit bull in the spirit realm. Yes, you are. You know what I kept hearing? I'm releasing healing and I'm releasing the spirit of adoption. When you were praying, that they cry out, Abba, Father. And so just remember this. You know, everything that you need is already within you. The DNA of God is already in you. And you need to look to Him because He's the only one that can really give you clarity and precision. God can send prophets. He can send seers. He can send words of knowledge or the Holy Word, which is the best word, let's get real, that you can listen and follow. But God will always bring a confirmation to where you need to be and where you need to go. He said, I sent them out two by two. So now I feel better already knowing that I'll be going to Germany with other women and guys, that we can go in and really witness and hit this. Because I'm telling you, many, many years ago when I came here in the very beginning with my son-in-law, Matthias van der Steen, and daughter Rebecca, I gave a word and people thought it was crazy, but I said there is a seat of a demonic authority that's going to be here and it has to do with the Muslims. And I'm telling you honestly, people laughed at me. I said, y'all have no idea. And within a matter of days, they were over by the waterfront and they started building this huge mosque. I was in Sweden 3 years ago and I said Friday night, I said, here, I don't know what this means, but here's going to be a mosque. And they said, well, that can't be. And I said, well, the Lord says in 3 days it's going to happen. And in 3 days, right where I put the X marks the spot, they started building a mosque in Sweden. I'm telling you right now, the borders are being infiltrated. And it's not about Muslims. It's about the darkness. Darkness has hit every land. It's not just Sweden. It's not America. It's not just Holland. It's the whole world. And if we do not start to come together united we stand, but divided we will fall. We must come against the darkness. We must be a voice. Can I tell you, in America, we shut our mouth for so long that we have lost so many rights in America because we shut our mouths. And now we have satanic, instead of Christians after school programs, they have Satan after school programs because they believe they have equal rights as well. Y'all ain't got no rights except to flipping get saved, or Satan will drag your soul to hell, because that's how that's going to roll. Like, somebody has to be a voice that will be like John the Baptist, prepare the way of the Lord. Yes. So y'all better get ready for what's coming, because God's moving quick. But you'll be seeing a lot more of my friends here that are watching, but you guys will be seeing a lot more of Pastor Yanni, and I know there's a lot of prophetic word in you that I'll get translated. We put it on the prophetic networks with us and our other media sites, and we'll get your stuff out there more. Are you writing a book? You need to.
I know.
I know you know, but that's not going to help me any. No. Jesus, God. Or as I like to say, Jesus, Mary of God. But I sense real strong, there's two scrolls behind you, and one of them is your journey from being ill. So does that make sense now?
Yeah.
But there are keys in there for other people that can help them be set free. Not that they have to go through what you went through, but that they can get set free.
Yep.
Okay. And the other one will be crazy about their glory or something fun. Anyway, listen, have an amazing week. And I close out my program every time. But remember to do something amazing for you this week. Pray for your pastors. Okay. Every week I tell the people, I know you think I'm like a broken record. Pray and be an Aaron unto your Moses. Pray, male or female, whoever they are, pray for your pastors. Don't be a hindrance. Don't be a milestone, a millstone around their necks. Lift up their arms and let them know that you love them. Stop tipping God. Stop giving him $5 when Malachi talks about the tenth belongs to God. Many of you want to see the outpouring of God, but it's not even about the tithe. God owns the world. It has to do with your offering. Where's your offering and sacrifice, you know? Where is that at the altar being burned, you know? God is looking for a people that know him. And that's why I love her, because she knows him. As long as we know God, the dynamic duo, honey, are here to stay. So have a great week. We love you, and I will see you soon. Ciao.